Yes, Carlos Ghosn came to Lebanon because it's his childhood home. He has Lebanese citizenship, and also because he knew he'd never get extradited back to Japan, where he was convinced he would never get a fair trial.
The only thing I want to tell you that a lot of people perceive this that I am running from justice, which is really the last thing I want to know. If I had some reassurance that I would get a fair trial in Japan, and if there was a possibility for my wife to join me in Japan, I would have stayed in Japan because this is the place where I should have defended my name and my reputation.
What if you have to spend the rest of your life in Lebanon, though? Are you ready for that?
Well, it's better than spending the rest of my life in Japan.
But today, he's facing issues that have nothing to do with Japan, but in fact have everything to do with the very bloody politics of the Middle East. He gave an interview to Lebanese TV this morning in which he acknowledged that he met with Lebanese officials today, and he was questioned about a formal complaint filed by a group of Lebanese lawyers who accuse him of, quote, normalization of ties with Israel. This all stems from a visit he made to Israel back in 2008, a long time ago, in which, and we can show you the pictures from that visit, he can be seen shaking hands with the then president of Israel, Shimon Peres, and also a guy named Shai Agassi. Longtime viewers of CNBC will be very familiar with Shai Agassi, who has been talking about electric cars, I think, even before Elon Musk. Lawyers for Carlos Ghosn have told Reuters that they are very comfortable with the way that the legal proceedings are happening here in Lebanon, so it's not clear that this is going to be a major issue, but it certainly highlights the situation here in Lebanon. This came up twice in the news conference yesterday from Lebanese reporters, this visit back to Israel, where one of them asked him, how could you shake hands with someone who has Lebanese blood on his hands? And remember, we're just in the wake of this strike that killed Soleimani. And Soleimani of Iran, the general of Iran, who was in charge of the Quds Force, it was his job to spread Iranian power throughout the region, and they support Hezbollah, which is now a member of the parliament here in Israel. So while Carlos Ghosn comes here trying to escape the situation in Japan, all of the politics that we have been talking about for the last week are all still very vibrant here, and he's going to have to deal with those issues.
And potentially be staying in that country for a very long period of time, as you asked him, which he seems willing to do, not having much choice otherwise, I guess, at this point, Michelle.
Yeah, no, as he said, he'd rather spend it here than being under house arrest in Japan and waiting for a very long time for justice there. His passport was taken away from him. We were told that was a standard procedure at this point. But in theory, at some point, perhaps he could travel to France because he does have French citizenship, French passport, which was taken away as well today. And they do not extradite their citizens as well. So in theory, he would be safe there, possibly. But it's not clear when and if he'll be able to go to France.